Good morning all. Today we are going to see the differences between the concentrated and distributed winding and what are the advantages of distributed winding. Why distributed winding is used for induction motor. So first let us see one by one. So concentrated winding is one in which all the winding is concentrated at a single point. So winding will be concentrated like this. So all the MMF will be concentrated at a single point. So first parameter is the shape of MMF wave in space. So shape of the MMF wave in the space will be like this. It will be in the rectangular form because all the flux, all the MMF is concentrated at a single point. So this is my MMF with respect to the space. So whereas if you go for the distributed winding, in the case of distributed winding, it becomes a trapezoidal where the angle between two adjacent will be beta. So it will increase like this. So similar way it will go on decreasing, and this will be in the opposite direction in the similar way. So you can see that this MMF wave, this will be nearly approximating to a sine wave. So the advantage of this is it will nearly approximate to the sine wave. So automatically the harmonics that will produce in your EMF will be less in the case of distributed winding, whereas in concentrated winding it is completely different to that of the sinusoidal wave. So this can be resolved into multiple frequency component. One is the fundamental components and the higher order harmonics. So many harmonics will be produced in the EMF that is induced. That is the disadvantage of this. So this wave is called as stepped wave, or it is also called as trapezoidal wave. So out of this wave, if you can make the angle between two slots, this beta is very small, this will approximate nearly to the sine wave. That is the advantage of distributed winding concerning about the MMF. Now coming to the EMF induced. So if you are going for the concentrated winding, the EMF induced in each conductor will add up. Let us assume there are four conductors. So EMF will add up EA, EB, EC and AD. So I can tell my resultant value of EMF is equal to EA plus EB plus EC plus ED, because all will be in phase with each other. Whereas if you go for the distributed winding, let us assume my slot angle is beta. So it can be represented like that with respect to the center. Let us assume this is my conductor position A. The conductor position A is having some EMF E. So conductor B will not have the EMF in the same phase. It will be displaced by some angle beta, where beta is the slot angle in electrical degrees. Remember here, these are electrical degrees, not mechanical degrees. So again, the third conductor, so it should pass like this. Again, it will be displaced by some angle beta. So this is my EMF E2. This is my EMF E3. So similar is the case for the fourth EMF. Fourth EMF will be E4. Again, this angle will be beta. So with respect to this, let us assume this is my radius. So the radius will be same for every point. So if you want to calculate the resultant value, so resultant value I can calculate as the vector sum of all these. So this is my vector sum. So this is my value of ER. Let us see how to calculate this. To calculate the value, I am just briefly discussing here. So detail we will discuss in synchronous machines. Anyway, to make the analysis easy, I am discussing here also. So A, B, C, D, and let us assume this point is E. So this each angle, this angle made will be equal to beta. So the total angle made, let us assume there are M conductors per pole per phase. There are M conductors per pole per phase. So total angle will be number of conductors multiplied by slot angle of each one, where the beta is equal to 180 degrees, because it is in electrical degrees, pole pitch is 180 degrees, divided by number of slots per pole, total number of slots per pole. Let us assume the total number of slots per pole is equal to n. This becomes 180 divided by n, where n is the number of slots. So here the value of m beta is called as the phase spread angle. So generally this is represented by rho. So let us try to calculate this. So to calculate this, what I can do, I can take a bisector perpendicular to this. So it will be perpendicular. So this is having a triangle. This is my side and this is my hypotenuse. this is my side and this is the opposite side. So this angle will become beta by 2. So from this I can calculate my value of AB is equal to E1 is equal to, or E is equal to 2 into R, this is 2 times of R into sin beta by 2. We know sin beta by 2 is opposite by hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is my radius. So opposite side is my voltage E1 by 2. So from there I can calculate E1 is equal to 2R sin beta by 2. So total arithmetic sum, if you take the arithmetic sum, total there are total m conductors. So this becomes m into 2R into sin beta by 2. So if you want to calculate their vector sum, so vector sum is nothing but equal to AE. So AE also I can calculate in the same way. So this will be equal to 2R into sin of, total angle is m beta. So this becomes m beta by 2, sin of m beta by 2. So the distribution factor is defined as the vector sum of coil EMF divided by arithmetic sum of coil EMF, or the EMF induced in the case of concentrated winding, and the numerator is EMF induced in the case of distributed winding. If you substitute these equations, so RR will cancel, 2 will cancel in both the cases. So this will become sin m beta by 2 divided by m sin beta by 2. Sin of m beta by 2 divided by m sin beta by 2. So this is called as the distribution factor. So the employing the distribution factor, the disadvantage is by using the distributed winding, your EMF will not be equal to your normal EMF. It will be less than your EMF. So what will be the EMF? So less than the EMF, it will be equal to sin of m beta by 2 when extra term is adding. So it is not equal to your normal EMF. Or you can tell that the EMF induced in the case of distributed winding is equal to EMF induced in the case of concentrated winding multiplied by the distribution factor. So this distribution factor I am representing by KD. So if I want to calculate E1 per phase is equal to 4.44 n phase phi maximum into F into, I have to multiply with the distribution factor. So then I will get it. So let us see what will be the case of this distribution factor for different components or different harmonic components. So if I am taking the harmonic component M is equal to 3, so the distribution component becomes sin of 3 beta by 2 divided by 3 sin beta by 2, where beta is the slot angle in electrical degrees. Getting it? So if the value of beta is very small, if the value of beta is very small, so upon I can approximate my sin beta by 2 as beta by 2 in radians. So therefore the value of KD will become equal to sin of m beta by 2 divided by m beta by 2, or this I can write as sin of the phase spread angle divided by phase spread angle. Phase spread angle, so is m beta, right? So this will become phase spread angle divided by 2 beta divided by phase spread angle by 2. So let us see for nth harmonic what will be the value of the distribution factor. So I am writing the distribution factor for nth harmonics. This n indicates for n harmonics. So this will become sin, this will be multiplied by n because nth harmonic will rotate at n times the velocity. So automatically the angle also becomes n times. So this become m into n beta by 2, this slot angle becomes n times divided by m sin n beta by 2. This is the value. Similar is the case. So if I want to calculate for the case of fifth harmonic, so this will become sin of 5 beta by 2 divided by m sin 5 beta by 2. So here I forget to write m, right? Okay, m into sin 5 beta by 2 divided by m sin 5 beta by 2. So it is observed practically that the KdF for the fundamental component will be always greater than KdF for the higher order harmonics. So that means if you are employing the distributed winding, the distribution factor will go on decaying as for the higher order harmonics. So as a result of this, we can tell that the EMF induced for the higher order harmonics will be less than that of the fundamental harmonics. So let us try to calculate what will be the EMF induced per phase for fundamental component and EMF induced per phase for higher order harmonics. So EMF induced per phase will be equal to 4.44 N phase into phi maximum into fundamental. So frequency is f only, this will become KdF. So if you want to calculate for fifth harmonic will be 4.44 N phase phi maximum. This is fifth harmonic, so frequency is phi times the frequency multiplied by KdF. And in the similar way we have to do it. So the major difference between the concentrated and distributed winding, I am just summarizing here. In the case of concentrated winding, the EMF induced is more. So EMF induced is equal to this KD, distribution factor, times. So EMF induced in the case of concentrated winding. So that means EMF induced is less than that of the concentrated winding. So the third difference between these two. So as the order of harmonics increases, if you are distributing your winding, that will have the advantage that harmonic component will be suppressed. So how? Let us take for example for the fifth harmonic E5 for the concentrated winding. So for concentrated winding will be equal to 4.44 N phase into phi f into the distribution factor is 1. So whereas in the case of E5 for the case of distributed winding, so this will become 4.44 N phase into phi f into there is a distribution factor. So we know that always the KdF or KD is always less than 1, and sometimes it is much more less than 1. So automatically we can tell that by distributing the winding along different slots of the periphery, so automatically EMF wave becomes more sinusoidal, or the harmonics in the EMF will be decreased. So I am just summarizing that harmonic EMF is decreased by distributing your winding. Okay, there are basically two advantages I am summarizing. The two advantages is, first one is your MMF becomes more sinusoidal, or it is a trapezoidal wave, it is approaching near to the sine wave. And the second one, the harmonic contents are less because the harmonic EMFs are less for the higher order harmonics because of this distribution factor when compared to the concentrated winding. But the disadvantage is EMF per phase is decreased because the EMF is not simple the scalar sum, the EMF will be the vector sum. Because of that, the EMF is decreased by the factor of KD, the distribution factor. That is the only limitation of the distributed winding. But due to the advantages of the distributed winding, other advantages are dominating, so we always go for the distributed winding. So let us go to the different types of windings. So again, in the distributed winding, the windings can be divided into different categories. The first one is the full pitched winding. And the second one is short pitched winding, or it is also called as fractional pitched winding. So what does it mean? So if you take your machine, let us assume the poles are there. This is my north pole. So two adjacent poles will be of opposite polarity. This will be south, this will be north, and this will be south. So we know that the EMF induced will be equal to 180 degrees when your conductor is crossing a pair of poles. That means it is crossing from N to S. So this I name as one pole pitch, or this is nothing but 180 degrees electrical. The EMF induced will be 180 degrees electrical. So if your winding is kept in such a way that two sides of a coil are displaced by 180 degrees electrical, then it is called as the full pitched coil. This is called as coil span, the span between two sides of a coil. So this is called as full pitched coil. So full pitched coil advantage is, whatever is the EMF here will be just 180 degrees opposite to the EMF induced. For example, if EMF induced is plus minus here, it will be minus plus, because if this is under north pole, this will be under south pole, because 180 degrees opposite. So automatically, if you take the sum of the EMFs, the EMF induced in these two will add directly to each other. But now, there are some advantages of going for the pole pitch lesser than your full pitch. So that winding is called as the short pitch winding. In the case of short pitch winding, so we keep the winding less than 180 degrees. So this gap is less than 180 degrees. So this difference is a factor defined by the cording angle or cording factor. So let us assume they are decreased by an angle of cording angle. So these outer side conductors, these are called as overhangs. So why we are discussing that, we will discuss as we are coming to. So first thing you should know, that we know that theta electrical is equal to P by 2 times of theta mechanical. So this you have seen in basic electrical engineering as well as the basics. So I am not going into that. So value of the alpha or the cording angle is 180 degrees electrical minus what is the coil span. What is the actual coil span? So that much is my value of the alpha, because in this case the coil span is this much, the coil span is decreased. So let us see what is the difference between full pitch and that of the half pitch. So in a full pitch coil, let us assume the EMF induced in each conductor is ES, then the total EMF will be equal to 2 times of ES. But whereas if you go for a short pitched coil, let us assume this is ES. So instead of ES being like this, because you are short pitching by some angle, so by the same angle your EMF will be shifted. So this will become ES. So your resultant EMF will be this much. So this will become equal to 180 degrees minus alpha. So if you calculate my resultant value of EMF, resultant value of EMF will be equal to 2 times of EF into cos alpha by 2. You can try to derive it, you will get this value. So we can tell that by employing the short pitched winding, the EMF induced per the coil is decreased when compared to a full pitched coil. How much it is decreased? That factor is defined by the factor called as cording factor or pitch factor, which is represented by Kp. Kp will be equal to cos alpha by 2. Cos alpha by 2. So it will decrease by a factor of cos alpha by 2. What is Kp? Kp I am defining, it is the EMF induced in short pitched coil divided by EMF induced in full pitched coil. Always the Kp also will be less than 1. So if you want to calculate the net EMF, because of the distributed winding, so net EMF, what you have to do, whatever is the EMF in concentrated winding, which is 4.44 N phase into phi maximum into F. So this you have to multiply one with the pitch factor as well as the distribution factor. Distribution factor we have seen before, and one more term is added now, that is pitch factor, depending on how your winding is made. So if it is a full pitched coil, then Kp is equal to 1. If it is a short pitched coil, accordingly it will decrease. It will become equal to cos alpha by 2. So this product of this Kp and Kd is called as the winding factor, because these two factors came because of the type of the winding you have employed. So it is represented by Kw. It is the type of the winding factor. So now, the value of Kp, pitch factor, we have defined is equal to cos alpha by 2. So for nth harmonic, the value of Kp will be equal to cos of, because nth harmonic rotates at n times the frequency. So that means within 180 degrees, when the fundamental component can complete, the nth harmonic can complete n cycles, n times of 180 degrees. So automatically the angle, this angle, cording angle will become n times. So this will become n alpha by 2. This is for nth harmonic. So we can tell that the cording factor for the fundamental component will be greater than the cording factor of fifth harmonic will be greater than cording factor of seventh harmonic. So as the order of the harmonics are increasing, the cording factor will increase. So it is observed that practically in the case of induction motor, the seventh harmonic is most dominating. So So why the seventh harmonic is dominating and other things we are going to discuss in detail in the lectures where we are going to teach in the coming lectures the harmonics of three phase motors. So once I complete all the basics, then I will go for the harmonic analysis, because once the basics are cleared, analyzing the harmonics will be easy. So all together I will explain all the type of harmonics and how to overcome them, and everything I will discuss in the harmonics separately. So here whatever required for the flow, only those things I am discussing. So remember here, the seventh harmonic is most dominating. If you want to delete the seventh harmonic, so if you want to delete the second harmonic, if I can make my pitch factor is equal to 0 for seventh harmonic, that means KP7 is equal to 0, automatically the EMF induced will be 0. So the harmonic component will be completely nullified. So what I have to do, so the KP7 is equal to 0, this is equal to cos 7 into alpha by 2. This should be equal to 0. So from this I can calculate my value of what is the angle of alpha required. So if you calculate the value of alpha, so alpha required will be equal to 180 degrees divided by 7, or this I can write in a generalized statement, by properly choosing the value of alpha in such a way that n alpha by 2 is equal to k times of pi by 2, because cos 90 is equal to 0, that thing we know, where n is the order of harmonic and k is any odd multiple, or we can tell that odd integer, simply we can write, any odd integer, because we know that for 90 degrees as well as 3 multiplied by 90 degrees, 5 multiplied by 90 degrees, all these angles, the cos of the angle will become equal to 0. If k is even, that means for 180 degrees the cos value will be equal to 1 or minus 1. So that is the disadvantage of this. So that's why k should be equal to odd multiple. So in that case, that particular harmonic component can be completely nullified. But there is an advantage of employing the short pitched coil. So that I am going back, I told you before, just remember it, we are going to come back. This winding overhangs are decreased by employing the short pitched coil. The winding overhangs are decreased. It is observed practically that the amount of conductor saved due to this winding overhangs, decreasing the winding overhangs, dominates the amount of extra turns required to compensate for decrease in the EMF. So that is another advantage. That means when compared to a full pitched coil, the short pitched coil requires less amount of copper. That is the advantage, because winding overhangs are absent. There is one more advantage of decreasing the winding overhangs. As the winding overhangs decreases, the amount of flux that get wasted, because whichever flux is linking with this overhangs will be useless. So the amount of flux that is linking with overhangs is decreased. So automatically your efficiency of your system will improve. So that is the advantage of short pitched coil. So I am just summarizing the short pitched coil. So short pitched coil, generally seventh harmonic is most dominating. So I want to make that cos of 7 alpha by 2 should be equal to 0. Or we can tell this 7 alpha by 2 should be equal to 90 degrees, or alpha is equal to 180 degrees divided by 7. So by employing angle 180 degrees by 7 alpha value, so automatically 7 harmonic components will be completely nullified. So always in an induction motor, the winding is short pitched by an angle equal to 180 degrees divided by 7. So I hope these are clear to you. So next class we are going to see the construction of the rotor, that is squirrel cage rotor construction. So why it is like that, advantage, disadvantages, and then we go for the wound rotor construction. So if you have any queries, or if you feel that some concept is missed by me, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. I will answer to your queries from there, and if required, I will try to prepare one separate small video and upload it. Thank you. Thank you very much.